Hi, this is Robby Johnson, and I'm going to be going over the steps I go through to create color keys. And the overall basics are applying local colors to each of the individual objects, doing an overall hard light layer that affects the color temperature of everything, and then using overlay layers to apply direct light or just form light.
To start the image, I've made three layers for tones: the foreground structure, the foreground sand mound, and the background landscape. I'm selecting the foreground structure layer, and I'm applying a hue saturation adjustment by pressing Ctrl U. I check the colorize box at the bottom right, and it allows me to add color to a grayscale layer, and then I find the color I want using the sliders. By Ctrl-clicking the icon of the foreground structure layer in the Layers tab, I can make the foreground structure my selection. Then I make a new folder, and by clicking the Add Layer Mask button on the bottom of the Layers tab, I can ensure that everything I do within the folder only applies to the foreground structure. This allows me to make quick and inaccurate selections while only affecting the structure. Now I'm going through and changing the color of the other ground layers using Ctrl U again. I'm only thinking of the local colors of the objects, I'm not thinking of how light affects them. Kind of as if they were in an equally lit white room. While looking at references of different times of day, I'm deciding what kind of sky I want and using the gradient tool on low opacity to build up the sky. Now I'm going to break up the monotony of the stone by making new layers and using selections and fills. Two hotkeys I use all the time are Alt Backspace to fill with your foreground color and Control Backspace to fill with your background color. Within the foreground structure group, I select all of the color layers I've made and create a new group called color. Then I create a separate group also inside the structure group called light. Inside the light layer, I create a new layer and set the blending mode to hard light. The hard light layer is one of the more important parts as it allows you to affect the entire scene with an identical color temperature. Now I'm going to again use the polygonal lasso tool to select the areas of the foreground that will be hit with direct light. I've decided the sun is going to be lower on the horizon and behind us to the left. I make this decision based off where I think is going to make the most interesting shadow shapes and break up the objects clearly with a dark and light side.
So once I apply a hard light to everything, I'll take the polygonal lasso tool, I find it's easier than the regular one, and go over and select all the areas getting hit by light with, I'll try to get most of it with one lasso and then apply it at once.
I'm Alt-clicking with the lasso tool to remove from the selection the smaller detail area that will be in shadow. Then, inside a new layer set to the overlay blending mode, I fill the selection with white. Then I duplicate the layer, which doubles the intensity of the light. I then Ctrl-click one of the new light layers and delete that portion from the hard light layer. This makes the lit portion of the stone unaffected by the purple in the hard light layer. I'm doing the same thing I did with the structure and making a folder for the mound and creating a layer mask so that everything in the folder only affects the mound. And I add a white overlay layer to the parts I want to hit with sunlight. And through these next few steps, I'm using overlay layers to add light, duplicating the overlay layers, using Ctrl U to change the color of the overlay layers, and sometimes I'll be deleting the lit area from the hard light layer if I like the result. Now I'm going in and deciding to change the color temperature, the color of the light, the intensity of the light, and if I wanted to, the local color of the objects. Now I'm using the smudge brush to soften some of the shadows. Generally, the further away the shadow is from the object casting it, the softer the shadow. I've made a new overlay layer and am hand painting color variation and adding some more white light to the planes of the object that are facing more directly toward the light source. I'm creating a new folder where I can add fog or atmospheric perspective to create more separation between the foreground and the background. Now I'm using the lasso tool to select areas I think would be hit by sunlight. And I use the R button to rotate the canvas for no reason. I do this way too often, and I'm surprised it hasn't happened more during the video. Then, using the smudge brush again, I soften the forms of sand rolling over the hills and some of the edges of the shadows. Trying to think of ways to bring more attention to the focal point, I try intensifying the light on the structure or changing its color. Again, more hand painting with overlay to add light and bloom to different areas. The importance of all these adjustment layers and making sure not to paint on normal layers yet is so if and probably when you decide to go back and change the color of any of the objects in the scene, the adjustment layers will adjust to the objects underneath. And usually at this point in the painting is when I'd go over and do an ambient occlusion pass directly over the local color layer. But maybe that'll have to be the subject of my next ProTip video.